And welcome to another edition of Mondays with the Mayor. I am Mayor Clay Walker of the Denali Borough. It's good to be with you again. Thanks for watching. Thanks for tuning in. Thanks for staying informed. And there are multiple ways to do that. And this is one good venue to push out information and answer some questions that people have had. People have had questions about the economic impacts of the COVID-19 crisis, which is impacting everybody in the country and often in severe ways. And of course, we're not alone. We're together with a lot of folks in this crisis, and we're working together to get through it, as we're going to do. And I want to touch base on both local impacts and also impacts directly to the Denali Borough itself. A lot of local businesses are devastated by the cancellation of Cross Gulf crossings this summer, where no visitors will be coming in cruise ships across the Gulf, and we're going to have a greatly reduced season in terms of visitation. It's going to be very challenging for a lot of businesses here. A lot of local business owners are going to be hurt. So please do get out and shop or dine or visit the local businesses that are open. Let's support our local businesses this year. It's especially important. And I want to talk also a little bit about the impacts to the Denali Borough itself. I've had a lot of questions about that and talked with a lot of folks from the governor to our U.S. senators about those impacts, and they are severe. We are acutely susceptible or vulnerable to this downturn as 80% of our revenue does come directly from bed tax, from the overnight accommodations taxes paid by those folks coming off those cruise ships. But also we do have overland travelers, which we'll have some of this summer. So the Denali Borough was so well built, so well put together in those founding days, those founding years when we were established in 1990, when they put together this forward funding model of a borough and a fiscally conservative borough that would take on limited number of powers and have a limited number of taxes too. And because all of our eggs have been in one basket, we have been rather fiscally conservative over the years and have planned well. But that's not to say that this impact won't be big, and it will for the years to come. And that's what I want to talk about a little bit, how we're structured and how the impacts are both today, current, and down the line. We do have three things in our favor, real strong fiscal legs of our borough position. We have almost no debt, which is fantastic, amazing, rare among municipalities, and leads to these great ratios in terms of our financial statements and liquidity ratios and ways you look at, you know, the viability of an organization and the fiscal health. I mean, we rank high because we have no debt, basically, to speak of. We don't even have a car payment, which I'm proud of. And I think everybody who's been involved with this borough for many years should be, that we've operated in a fiscally responsible manner. We've also saved for the rainy day by keeping a healthy, unrestricted fund balance. It hasn't been excessive. And yeah, we have done some projects. When that balance gets a little big, we kind of look around and say, what are the real needs? And you know, we worked on building a Healy transfer station. And yeah, our fund balance did go down a little bit during that time. But at the same time, it is at a very healthy level. It is actually 56% of our general fund expenditures, which is a very high ratio. Credit rating agencies look for about a 17% unrestricted ratio in municipalities to lend to their obligation debts. Fairbanks North Star Borough is working towards building to 17% unrestricted fund balance ratio. Ours sits at 56. So there's another strong leg of our fiscal foundation. And then the third is our forward funding. Boy, that's unique. We're the only county in the country that I know of, and I've asked around a lot, who is forward funded, who is spending last year's monies. It's mandated. It's part of our code. It's part of the way we've operated since day one. And it is a unique aspect of the borough that's really helped us to be able to plan for the future because we're spending last year's monies. So this budget year coming up, beginning July 1st, we're introducing the budget for is last year's monies. But we need to be conservatively spending those because there'll be less in the future year. So forward funding allows us to plan and to react in a measured way to something like a crisis. So while the impacts to the Denali borough itself are acute of this economic crisis, we are well built to blunt those impacts and work towards planning for the future. Planning for the future where we can deliver on our responsibilities to the school district, where we can deliver to the level of services that people expect in the borough, whether it's fire and EMS or library or other services. So we're gonna work on that and want you all to be informed of what our position is. It's healthy right now, and we want to keep it healthy for the future. And our charge as leaders is going to be to get us through this crisis with that nice tripod of our three-legged strong fiscal position intact. We're going to lean on it, but we don't want it to break, and we don't want to lean on it too hard in the years ahead. We want to keep that strong foundation that we have here in the Denali Borough. We're thankful for it and want it to continue. So that's a little bit about our fiscal position. And maybe on the next Mondays with the mayor, we could go into some of the budget priorities as we'll be unveiling that budget. Thanks for watching, everybody. Be safe out there. Take care. Enjoy the sun.